Hello all, in the previous class we have learned the decimals. The decimals place value chart. This we already have covered in the previous class. In this video, I will show you how to convert any fraction into decimal fraction. So should we start this video? You can see I have made here a circle and I have distributed the circle into 10 equal parts. Now, I'm going to shape its two parts. One and two. Now, how we can write the fraction of the shaded part? How many parts are there? 10 parts. And how many parts are shaded? Two parts are shaded. So, this is numerator and this is denominator. Okay? Now, we will learn how to convert this fraction into decimal fraction. So, if any number is written in the form of fraction, then the numerator is the dividend and the denominator is the divisor. It acts as dividend and this denominator acts as divisor. So, if we will write 2 in the place of dividend and 10 at the place of divisor. So, can we divide this 2 by 10? It is not possible. So, how we can do that? There is one way to do this. What is that? If any dividend is smaller than the divisor, then what we have to do? Here, we have to give 0 and point. Okay. If we will give 0 and point, then after we can give 0 at the dividend place. कोई भी dividend divisor से छोटा होता है, तो उसको solve करने के लिए quotient के place पे first we have to give 0 and then we have to give a decimal. Okay? And as soon as we will give 0 and decimal, we can add 10 to the dividend place. Okay. Now this dividend became 20. Okay. Now in the table of 10, can we find 20? Yes. We can find 20 in the table of 10 in 2 times only. So here we will write 2 and here we will write 20. And then we will subtract this. Then we will get 0. So, this is the quotient and this is the division fraction of this common fraction. Okay. So, 2 upon 10 we can write as 0.2. Now, here I have divided the circle into 100 equal parts. Now, suppose I will shade 2 its part. Then what I can write as a fraction? So it will be 2 upon 100. 100 equals parts are there and only 2 parts I have shaded. So as we have seen, 2 upon 10 is equal to 0.2. So how we can solve this now? Similarly, this is numerator and this is denominator. So denominator will become the divisor. So we will write now. क्या ये पॉसिबल है कि 2 को हम 100 से डिवाइड कर दें? नहीं, ये पॉसिबल नहीं है. तो फिर क्या करेंगे? जैसा हमने पहले देखा, first we have to give 0 and a dot. जैसे ही हम 0 and dot देते हैं, then we can add 0 here, at this place. ठीक है? अब तो ये 20 बन गया. Now this became 20. So, again, can we divide 20 by 100? Again, this is not possible. So, now what we have to do? Again, we will give 0 and point. No. If once we have given the point here, then no need to give again point. We have to give only 0. If we will add 0 at this place, then we can easily add one more 0 at this place. Okay? For the first time, we have to give 0 and point. And then after, we can only give 0. पहली बार हमें जीरो और पॉइंट दोनों देना है फॉर 10. अगर फिर भी वो डिवाइड नहीं हो पा रहा तो वी हैव टू गिव सिर्फ 10. ओके आफ्टर दैट सो वी विल एड 0 हियर. नाउ दिस 200 कैन बी डिविजिबल बाय 100. इन द टू टाइम्स वी विल गेट 200. सो हियर 2/100 कैन बी रिटन एज 0.02. ओके सिमिलरली लाइक दैट सपोज इफ टू पार्ट्स ऑफ 1000 पार्ट्स आर सेडेड देन हाउ वी कैन राइट दिस फ्रैक्शन इनटू डेसिमल फ्रैक्शन. अगेन वी दिस इज द न्यूमरेटर दिस इज डिनोमिनेटर दिस विल बिकम डिवाइजर एंड दिस विल बिकम डिविडेंड. सो ये तो पॉसिबल नहीं है कि हम 2 को 1000 से डिवाइड कर दें. सो फर्स्ट वी विल गिव 0 एंड अ पॉइंट देन वी कैन एड 10. अगेन 20 भी 1000 से डिवाइड नहीं हो सकता देन वी विल एड 10 हियर एंड 10 हियर. नाउ दिस बिकेम 200 बट इट इज अगेन नॉट डिविजिबल बाय 1000. सो अगेन वी विल एड 10 हियर एंड 10 हियर. ओके नाउ इट बिकेम 2000 एंड इट इज इजिली डिविजिबल बाय नाउ 1000. इन द टू टाइम्स ओनली वी विल गेट 2000. So, this can be written as 2/1000 can be written as 0.002. Understood? Now, one pattern have you noticed here that denominator mein jitne zeros hain, decimal ke baad utne hi digits hain. Yahan denominator mein 10 hai, to yahan decimal ke baad 1 digit hai, that is 2. In this, in denominator we can find 2 zeros and here also we can find 2 digit after decimal. Here again 3 zeros and after decimal we have found 3 digits. So now I'm going to tell you the shortcut way to convert the fraction into decimal fraction. But the condition is the denominator should be 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 and so on. If the denominators are like this, then we can apply this shortcut method that I am going to teach you now. Okay, suppose it is 5/10. Then what we have to do here to convert this fraction into decimal fraction, this one we have to convert into 0. Okay, this one will become 0 and after this we have to give 1 dot. Okay, now how many digits are left in the denominator? 1. And how many digits are there in numerator? 1. So this 5 will go at the last position. This 1 will become 0 and after that we have to give a point and this 5 will go at the last position. It will become 0.5. Now, if it is 5/100, then what we have to do? Again, this one we have to convert into 0, then we have to give a point. Okay? And how many digits are there? 2 digits. But this 5 will go at the last place. Okay? And this we have to write as it is. This 0 we have to write as it is here. And this 5 will go at the last place. So this will become 0.05. Now if it is 5/1000. Again what we have to do? This 1 we have to convert into 0 and then we have to give a point. And after that we can see 3 digits are there. But this 5 will take the place of this 0 only. So how many zeros are more here? 2. We have to write 2 zeros here and this 5 will take the place of this 0. So this will become 0.005. Now suppose if it is 63/1000. Okay, then what we have to do? Again, this one will become 0, then point. Now, this 3 will go at the last position and this 6 will go at the second last position. Okay, this 63 we have to bring down. So, if this 63 will take the place of these two zeros, so 1 0 is here, 1 0 is remaining here. So, this 0 we have to write here and this place, the place of these 0 will be taken by 63. So, it will become 0.063. I hope this is now clear to you. You can easily convert any fraction into decimal fraction. One more thing I want to tell you, that if I am taking any number, decimal fraction, then this decimal fraction has two part. Okay. This is called whole number part or integral part. Okay. And this is the digit that comes after decimal is called decimal part. This is decimal part. And this zero is whole number part. Okay, any decimal fraction has two parts. One is called the whole number part or integral part. And the number that comes after the decimal point called decimal part. Understood? I hope this video will help you. So stay connected. Till then, goodbye.